Right then. This is what we are taking a look. And it's the PC NightFire. One of those games where people say that they just get the console version, meaning PS2, GameCube and Xbox. There is a GBA version as well, but and there's this is the OG release. This also means, you probably guessed it, I have another release at hand. This is the classics release. It looks ugly. Reminds me about the console version, this back cover. Also, ELSPA 11, PEGI 12. But if the front cover sucks with the classics, oof, the back, it's even worse. What comes to spines then? The classics, it looks better to me. Oh, nice. Software manual, EAC install guide, disk to sleeve. This is the OG disk one. It looks like that. Classics disk one. It looks like that. This sleeve is where the disk two normally is. Only my classics copy has this. The other one I got later did not have it. Disks were on top of each other, and the disk holder is not designed to do that. Sucked. But I recall that's how EA did the two-disk thing. It's not the only game that has that one. The Sims 2 is also one. Now what comes to disk 2? This is the disk 2. And this is the OG disk 2. And that's the classics disk 2. And the differences with these disks in general, if any, well, with disk 2, is cosmetic. The data on both disk 1s and both disk 2s, the exact same. And someone can probably confirm, but did the US release, that I know there's a big box with a dual case with two CDs, is it version 1.0? Because Europe got version 1.0a straight off. I'd like to get a confirmation. I don't like to talk with zings out of my ass. Anyways, EAC install guides. These things, they are the same between releases, just different paper. And the OG has it. It feels a bit cheaper, you know. It looks more bootleggy, the material, but it is legit, I'll tell you that. Same with the manual. It's different material. And how should I do this? Excuse me. I am having my reasons to do this. And this is the back cover. And I like how they changed the layout a bit at the top and that number, but the EAC install guide, it has this one in both. No trickery here. And there's another difference besides the back cover. There are other differences as well. This one. The back covers inside, it's nothing in the re-release, but the OG, it advertises some shaving thing. Is that from a Philips? The name would imply that PhiliShave. And that kind of stunner is in the console game. Can't recall if it was on PC as well. PhiliShave, James Bond's shaver of choice. This was actually pretty interesting to see. But yeah, otherwise the manual is exactly the same. And this is something I see on some console games, but on PC games as well. Warning to owners of projection televisions, that would be widescreen televisions if this would be in Finnish, oddly enough. And precautions to take, preferably play the game on a small screen. Yeah. That's the PC Master Race for ya. And that was Nightfire on PC. Interesting thing, now that I have the original release as well. And I can't multiplay, I'm sure there's a way to do that as well, but it goes to things that I do not do with games at all. And why don't you rub it in and say that how dare you not do this and that, and you are missing out or shit like that. I am perfectly aware what my choices cause, but that's how I roll. That was interesting actually to take a look at. You don't get all this shit with the digital, you know, these manuals, they're interesting to read. Interesting to look at all these things, if there's any differences, you know. But the point here is that data on the discs is the exact same, packaging different. Interestingly. Oh yeah, and the serial is different as well. but I am not going to show that, obviously. Goodbye, sirs, and all that jazz, and seriously, go play the console version.